Now, from from Andrew Lloyd Webber, from Jesus Christ Superstar to Evita, close to Cats, Andrew Lloyd Webber has written some of the world's most popular songs. Tonight's the opening night of his next big hit. It's Whistle Down the Wind, which, of course, was an old black and white movie with Hayley Bills and Alan Bates.
I said that. Now you see you're repeating me now.
Hayley Bills and Alan Bates.
Alan Bennett.
Here's the man himself, Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Playing
the title track.
So try and stem the tide, then you'll raise a banner, send a flare up in the sky, try to burn a torch, and try to build a bonfire. Every signal that you send, until the very end, I'm there.
Well, it gets a lot raunchier than that. Let's have a bit of a look at one of the hottest songs from the musical.
I want a fine perfume.
I want a blue carpet.
If there's a flow or a death, then living here and now.
They haven't found it yet.
I need a man who knows what I am really worth.
Well, I don't give a damn about life after death, but I gotta get some.
Nice one, hiya. Nice to see you.
That's a lot of energy.
And this is also the legendary lyricist Jim Steinman, who's written hit songs for everyone, from Meat Loaf to Bonnie Tyler.
Jim Steinman!
I know.
You are so
He's
famous.
Here. Jim's here. It's unbelievable.
And he's just spilt water all over.
Yeah, he's
just
spilt water.
How many hits have you had, Jim?
Congratulations.
How many hits have you had?
Oh, jeez.
Come on, roughly. 30?
Maybe. I mean, 17 number ones.
70? 70?
17. No, not 70.
No, 17. That'll do. 17 number ones. Cool. So Lloyd Webber wrote the tunes for this, and you write the words.
Andrew wrote the music. I wrote the words.
Cool.
When I do my own songs, I write both. But this, I'm very happy to write lyrics alone.
Yeah. I mean, it is completely different from the film because, for a start, it's set in America, not Yorkshire or wherever the film was set. Is that right?
Louisiana.
Louisiana.
And they've incorporated a different storyline. Because actually, in the old film, it was they found this convict lurking in the barn. And became convinced he was Jesus Christ.
That's still there. It's completely different, by the way. It's totally true to the essence of the movie, which Andrew and I happen to both adore.
And I actually worship.
We love that movie. Yeah. So it's totally true to the heart of it. But to open something up for a musical, you just need something that cries out for singing and dancing. So we just expanded a bit. We changed the setting to Louisiana, which is a great setting for music.
Yeah.
And it's 1959 anyway, the story, which was the time, the birth of rock and roll, the birth of teenagers, the birth of a kind of a whole new modern world.
And what are your parts?
Well, we're not actually in the original film. We've been injected into this through the 1959 right. rock and roll breakthrough in Louisiana, America.
So what do you
and we're the rebels.
Right.
But we're very important in the way the convict is arrested or taken away or whatever right. he's done at the end.
And I can't give is there some kind away. Of, as indeed there would have been in 1959 in Louisiana, some kind of racial
That's
tension?
Right, yeah. Right. I mean, our...
We're not supposed to be seen
Yeah, our characters are a couple, but everybody knows about it, but it's like a secret that right. they all know about, but, you know, it's...
A black girl and a white guy just doesn't happen.
And are you kind of passing through, or are you from
Well, we want to get out. We want to get out.
Our dream is to escape. I've got a Harley Davidson.
Hey, we're saying it's 7:59 and it was bad then. What about what happened in Texas last week? You know, black guy was chained to the lorry.
A lot of things haven't changed.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Incredible.
But 1959 was the start of a new era. That's when things began to change.
What's the atmosphere like? I mean, because, you know, Lloyd Webber musicals are a big deal, you know, when they get going, and tonight's the first night. Is everybody very tense about it?
Fantastic cast. I mean, Marcus Levitt, who plays the convict. Yeah. Fantastic guy to work with. He's been on Broadway and everything.
You saw Lottie earlier.
And Lottie Mayer, who's the star of the show. She's like the juvenile female lead.
Right.
Fantastic. Great. Really pleasure to work with them all.
And it's preview tonight, but it
previews tonight and opens July 1st.
July 1st at which theatre?
The Aldwych Theatre.
The Aldwych.
Wonderful theatre.
Yeah. Okay. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
I love your jewellery. Look at that.
Do you like my jewellery?
Yeah.
It's all yours.
You're
a goth. My skull tie.
Yeah. I'm goth.
I mean, sorry, goth. I'm on the wrong medication. It's hard to say.
If they only played one of the songs, only one of the songs that you'd written outside this musical, because you've done enough plugs for that, what would it be?
Probably Total Eclipse of the Heart.
Yeah, for Bonnie Tyler.
I love that.
It's a good song. The
Heart. I won't ruin it for you. Let it remain your favourite.
Good to see you. Good luck.
Good luck.
Now, as we said before, it is the 2000th programme. Oh, no, we can't keep saying this all day.
Yes, we can.
Going to drive you all nuts. But if you just tuned in, it is the 2000th programme tomorrow. How about that? 2,000 shows?
That's pretty
good. That's more than Phantom of the Opera, that is.
Yeah, but I have 2,000 hairs.
Fair enough. So, I've done it now.
Oh, no!
We're all passing the water now.
Yeah, God.
I told you it was usually my trick. Actually, I meant his. I was being polite.
That was my headmaster used to say that. He used to say, could fetch a cloth, wipe it up, boy. All right, sorry about that. We're overrunning here, so I better get overrunning. Anyway, it's the 2000th programme tomorrow, so we're all very nostalgic this week. Even Brian, he's been reminiscing about his favourite This Morning recipe ever.